This segment brought to you by Kansas Wheat. Learn more at rediscoverwheat.org.
Good morning again, folks. I am Romolo Lolato, Extension Wheat and Forage Specialist with Kansas State University. And now we're going to talk about the second part of the wheat quality tour. If you missed the first part, make sure and you watch it online, the first part of the trip that we just discussed. In the second part, we're going to discuss the trip that we made leaving Kobe, covering the entire southwest part of Kansas and heading from the southwest, covering the southern tier of county of Kansas into Wichita. So what did we see in that second day? So early morning, again, we were in that western turn of the state where it was covered in snow. So very hard to get any type of yield estimates. We're seeing quite a bit of broken stems. We're also seeing that possibly the heads that were held above snow, they got wind damage just because we had 40-50 miles per hour wind. So to some extent, snow in that region may have acted as a buffer or as an insulating for those colder temperatures and high winds that we saw. But again, the crop was exposed to several hours of freezing temperatures, even if it is covered by snow. And the crop there in southwest was more advanced, was closer to antesis. So I really advise producers in that region as well to be scouting for freeze damage before they take any management decision. So again, mechanical damage from broken stems as well as freeze damage. Another big concern that I had out in southwest Kansas, especially as we were heading south of Tribune, was the infection of wheat streak mosaic, the severity of infection in the fields, as well as the incidence, fields that were just taken by the wheat streak mosaic in that far southwest Kansas. So that reminds me to remind you to be a good neighbor and control your volunteer wheat during the summer so we don't run into the situation of fields where we're seeing maybe 70-100% yield loss in that part of the state. As we move towards eastern Kansas in the southern tiers of counties, we start to get more into fields that were showing quite a bit of nitrogen deficiency. And the reason for that nitrogen deficiency are pretty much two. One, producers were probably not applying as much just because of the nitrogen price, right? The budget in nitrogen is not really paying off much this year. Second reason, we had quite a bit of rainfall as well. So the rainfall may have leached some of that nitrogen through the root zone. So even in fields that producers applied nitrogen, we're still seeing a lot of nitrogen deficiency. And that is going to hurt our yields as well, because on those cowpox where the crop was really expressing its potential, well, maybe we could see 70 bushels per acre wheat, but really when you average the field out, it might be only 35 or 40, just because of nitrogen deficiency. Another concern that we were seeing was waterlogged, especially in south central Kansas. A lot of fields showing waterlogged, which producers can't really do much about. That comes back to the amount of rainfall that we have been having. So in the wrap up of the tour, the final calculator number was 282 million bushels being produced out of the 2017 Kansas wheat crop. But folks, I want to make sure here that a lot of that final number is going to depend on the fate of that crop out in western Kansas. If the crop is able to bounce back, even though despite the stem bendings that we saw and also the freeze damage, maybe that 282 might realize. But really, we have too many things playing this year, so at this point, it's really early for us to give any final estimate of wheat production in Kansas.
Ag Promo Source is a unique group of marketing specialists with one mission: help your ag business grow. Each affiliate has their own area of expertise, and they work together to bring you advice, products, and services. To get started, visit agpromosource.com. Ag Promo Source, together we grow.